feeling like a savage. Ow. Oh. I look a lot worse than I feel, Will Snitters. I hope, how you doing? Yeah, alright, welcome back to another video. If you're new, where on earth have you been? Backflip hit the subscribe button. It's an interesting time for Mr. Niall Wilson. I've just undergone serious neck surgery, as you can see by the scar in the front. I don't think I actually mentioned in the previous log, it went through the front of the neck.
No! God, please, no!
I'm sure it was quite obvious, and we're going to talk a little bit more about it. Painful as f***. Speaking of pain, I need some painkillers.
So what they've put me on is dihydrocodone that gets you on such a good level, I'm not even gonna lie to you. And paracetamol. Two of these bad boys sorts me right out. We're 3 days after surgery and I do feel so much better this morning, so much better, like the swallowing. I managed to sleep around 10 hours last night and there was no after anesthetic. It proper knocks you out, so I've just been napping, sleeping. Very, very happy with how it's going.
And also, when you're on Cody, it proper constipates you, like, bad.
No!
I was taking it last week before the surgery when I had horrendous nerve pain. Took it 4 days in a row so as I came off it.
It ripped my bum all apart.
I don't know, that's not necessary. Apologies. Swear to God. 4 days wiping blood. But not this time. We're prepared this time. We've got some lactulose to help counteract the constipation. It's good times for the Wilsonator. 15 millilitres, morning and night, does the job. Firstly, guys, I just want to say a massive thank you. It's day 3 post-surgery, so I woke up, I posted the vlog and Instagram last night. The messages, the support is, oh my God, I just love all you guys. It does mean the world and it makes such a difference. We're grinding away, we're feeling much better now to be able to pick up a camera, to sit at a computer, just to do things. I think I'm going to take my first steps outside the flat today. So day 3, we're going to go for a little walk.
Woo!
The scar is looking so neat. I'll tell you a funny story, right? So, me being me, I'm laying on my bed and I just wanted to watch some YouTube or Netflix or something. When I was laying back, I couldn't really move my neck forwards. And you know, it's sometimes challenging to get comfortable in the bed with the laptop. So I was laying flat on my back, the laptop fully open, on my chest like that, so I could just lay back and see what was on the screen. Anyway, I was kind of nodding off, and as I'm nodding off, the laptop slid and I'm laying on my back. I don't think my support team want to hear this. It just slid and just jabbed me in the throat, right on my scar. And it started seeping. As you can see, it looks like it's been bleeding a little bit. That is from that, yeah. The thing to remember is in a time like this that each day is one day further away from the surgery. And they're just assessing how I feel. The way I feel right now is a million times better to day one. So we're freaking grateful. We're happy. We're practicing gratitude. That reminds me. Let's do the meditation.
Changing the game.
As mentioned in the previous vlog when I thanked my sponsors, I am now partnered with the Kettlebell Kitchen. Literally, guys, game changer. I'm not even lying to you. So they send me 3 meals a day, Monday to Friday, a box, a package on Monday and a Thursday. Just listen to some of these. Chicken and bacon carbonara, Cajun steak with charbroil, corn, chipotle, yogurt, chicken tikka masala, beef teriyaki with noodles, hot health English breakfast. The quality and the variation of the food is just spot on. This is going to help me so much and be crucial on these early parts and early stages of rehab, because honestly, for quickest healing with something like this, it's your lifestyle, it's your health. Sleeping as much as you can, eating and drinking as healthy as you possibly can, and getting the right nutrients in to aid healing and dropping the inflammation. So, boom. I am feeling so, I don't know what the word is, just non-athletic, if that makes sense. I've not done any gymnastics or physical exercise for over 2 weeks now, and it's going to be kind of another 2 weeks, so we're going to be a full month without gymnastics and exercise. So obviously my body's going to look probably even worse. Once you get back into training, the quick transformation that I can hopefully will be able to make will be so inspiring, and I cannot wait to freaking smash it out, I'm telling you.
Look at these fellas down here. Look at these fellas. Canoeing down, bloody Leeds Dock.
See, also I've got a really nice couple of words from my parents, Ma and Pa. Roll the clip.
So, we're here again, Sally, aren't we? Over the last 10 years, probably longer, we are no strangers to dealing with injury setbacks. So now, one of the things that I wanted to say was, whenever Niall rings me and something hasn't gone quite right, he'll say, it's not good, Dad. So I know that there's something negative coming. And I think from a gymnastics perspective, my biggest fear is always that it's going to be the call where it's followed up with, the career has ended. Difficult call to take, because the neck problems that you've been having over the last year that kept him out last year have continued and seriously worse. The dreams and goals from a gymnastics perspective are still the same. So surgery was the answer, so Nyla's fully committed to the surgery and recovery program and everything that he needs to go through with these next few rehab program.
I'm just delighted that he's still my beautiful boy.
Yeah.
Always will be.
Always will.
And now he's got a savage scar on his neck.
Oh! Am I not your beautiful boy?
No.
Well, thanks for that bombshell, Sally.
You're something very different.
The point I was going to make, though, Sally, was our love for Niall and being part of his journey has nothing to do with gymnastics and his results, has it?
He's still my beautiful boy.
And he's still my beautiful boy, and we love him to bits, and we're incredibly proud of him, and that's what we are, aren't we?
Always will be.
Isn't it? Shh. Don't say any more, Sally, in case he hears it.
Niall, unconditional.
I've just found out your mum's beautiful boy, so I don't know what makes me.
Yeah.
Can I go finish tidying now?
Okay, welcome to Wilsonator's gymnastics news. But it's not news, it's fails. We've got WGN, WGF. Oh, it still hurts to swallow. That's going to be interesting. Basically, you've got a very injured gymnast who just had neck surgery watching a compilation of gymnastics fails from every time zone. Could be back in the 1970s because, you know, part of the sport is we do stuff with the body that's not designed to happen and sometimes it goes wrong. Simple as that. I'm not sure many people who enjoy watching these, but it's going to be fun to react. We're going to make this a weekly thing. Obviously, while I'm injured, I cannot do lots of physical gymnastics cool stuff in my body. So we're going to watch people fall flat on their face and laugh at them. I'm struggling to laugh because of my neck pain. You want to smash the like button because we are the coolest gymnastics review channel in the internet. I think we're the only one. But the best out of one, in my eyes, is still the best, isn't it, Mum? Here we go then. Let's see what we got on today's agenda. To put a landing on your head one in there. Beijing Olympics. They're quite challenging. That's quite a famous gymnastics fails video actually from the men's side. A lot of them from Beijing. The first one being an absolute legend, the Japanese gymnast Tamita, and I remember watching that all around comp and you know everyone who kind of back in that era wanted him to win. And he always used to make one error and that was in the all-round final. Pung off rings to land on his side and missed out on a medal. Gutted for you, bro. Let's just lighten these up. Here we go, we've got Furby. The greatest gymnastics fail of all time. I remember that because I was there as a junior at that competition and Per was actually up with sickness. He had a bug all night, so he was really, really ill that day. And he was like, you know what, I'm a trooper. I'm going to compete for the team. He's just announced his retirement from competitive professional gymnastics. And I just want to say, Daniel Purvis, you are an absolute legend. One of the nicest guys I've ever met on this planet. A true inspiration, a true gent. And I'm sure everyone in the gymnastics world is wishing you all the best and a happy retirement, brother. I will see you very soon. Let's just have a moment for Daniel Purvis. Epke Zonderland, 2016 Olympic high bar final. On to his face, and I kid you not, this is a cool story, so not that many people know this. He was second up on high bar. I was in this final and I was third. I was going after him. I was really, really shaken up after watching that. You know, you've got the previous Olympic champion from 4 years ago going up. He went boom, splat on his face, and I had to go up next. Times like that, it's where your mental toughness can really step in. Yeah, it just shows you anything can happen in gymnastics. And I think if he'd have hit his routine, I got bronze, remember, things would have been different,
but he didn't.
Oh, I've seen this before. It's Marianne Dragulescu. No, no. Oh, my God. Why do people watch these videos? That is such a bad ankle roll. Oh, I can't do it. I can't watch that. We've got Hamish Carter on parallel bars. Oh my gosh! So I do that skill and it recently upgraded to an E. Basically they changed the rules on the underbar and the somersault elements and they upgraded this one so you kind of go under, do a double back and catch again in upper arms, and I've got a video of myself doing it. So everyone wanted to try it and I guess it's not for everyone, is it, Hamish? On the topics of teammates, Hamish has gone over to the Illinois, you know, the college gymnastics scheme over there, and he seems like he's having an absolute incredible time. Big love to you, Hamster. I hope you're absolutely smashing it out there, Miley. What's he doing? I think what's happened there is either winding up for a catch-up or a dismount because he's really pushed his hips forward and obviously the bar's just completely slipped off. Ashley Watson, what are you doing, sir? Ash the Bear, best pal, he's always doing, or he's always used to be doing mad stuff on Instagram, so make sure you're following him. So that is it for the vlog, Wilsonators, week one of the rehab journey. Wilsonators, gymnastics, fails, reactions, and I hope you put a smile on your face and backflip into that subscribe button if you're not a part of this journey. We're gonna smash it, 6 months worth of rehab, one day at a time, and if I can inspire you along this journey, that makes the world to me. Remember, we've got the merch restock live. Get your merch, join the movement, and also the Body Barber 4-week shred team. We've not spoken about it too much in these last couple of weeks. Absolutely changing the game. We hit an article on MTV's website, the top three workout programs for 2019. How incredible. The transformation success that we are getting is absolutely insane. And I'm actually thinking about giving away some incredible prizes reaching the month of March for the best transformations. So we're going to do the same for January, February, and March. We want to see who can get the most inspiring transformation over the 28 days. I'm certainly going to be doing it once my neck settles down after the operation. Those first 4 weeks, they're going to be getting back into fitness. Lots of love. Trent's back. Keep it real. See you later. Yeah. I'm gonna throw it.